Warning: The Savage Nation contains adult language, adult content, psychological nudity. Listener discretion is advised. And now, America's most exciting radio talk show, The Savage Nation, home of borders, language, culture. And here he is, Michael Savage.
Only the rednecks can save America. Welcome to the Savage Nation. Here we are facing the worst brand of human scum, if you even want to call them human, that the planet has ever seen. The worst brand of human scum the planet has ever seen. And what we have is a tepid response from the White House. From neutron bombs to neutered bombs in one administration. Meanwhile, the Honduran flu is spreading through our schools. That's right. Remember they used to call it the Asian flu? You were allowed to say where it came from. When you were in high school, maybe, you're still going, oh, yeah, well, it was brought in from Asia. Well, now we have the Honduran flu spreading through our schools because of the geniuses in the White House. The Honduran flu is here. Why do I say that I know for sure, with a high degree of certainty, that the outbreaks of this virus are directly related to the unaccompanied children that Obama has dumped all over America? Well, the only way to tell for sure is to culture the virus, and see if you can trace it back to Honduras or Nicaragua, where it's endemic. But the fakers inside the health departments of America refuse to even do the basics of public health. But let me say this to you who are skeptical of the fact that this president has committed a crime against our children. You say, well, wait a minute, Michael. We can't be sure that it's the children, the unaccompanied children from Guatemala and Honduras and El Salvador that are bringing this virus across America, can we? You say, well, why didn't we see regional outbreaks of this virus in the border states where the kids were? Well, let me give you a simple answer. And let me remind you of something else. I'm not just a talk show host. I earned my PhD in epidemiology and human nutrition from the great University of California at Berkeley. And let me tell you the answer to that question, because there's not a public health official in America who will dare tell you a scintilla of the truth anymore. They're owned lock, stock, and barrel like prostitutes in a bordello. The answer is very simple. The reason you did not see regional outbreaks of this virus in the border states when these children were being kept there is because these children were not kept in school. They were hidden on military bases in large rooms. And then Team Obama shipped them all over the nation. And these viral outbreaks began after the illegals were placed in local schools. And let me remind you of something else from Dr. Michael Savage. All the people on the military bases knew these children were sick. Did you know that? Did you know that all of the military personnel and contractors who work with these unaccompanied minors were forced to sign a document which said they would not disclose any information or face jail time? That's your president. That's Team Obama that doesn't like people knowing what he's doing to America. Vaccine-associated paralytic poliomyelitis is next. Did you know about that? Poliomyelitis might be next. Oh, yes, it was found in an immigrant child with severe combined immunodeficiency syndrome in Texas in 2013. And today on the Savage Nation, amongst other things, I'm going to help you connect the dots on EVD68, which is spreading amongst our school children. That's the enterovirus, in case you don't know what I'm talking about. Meanwhile, in New York City, the Democrats are seeking citizen rights for illegal immigrants. You heard me. New York Post, Dateline today on the Savage Nation. Illegal aliens in New York could score billions in Medicaid and college tuition money, along with driver's licenses, voting rights, and even the ability to run for office if Democrats, the new brown shirts, win control of the state Senate in November, the New York Post has learned. They put forth a little-known bill called New York is Home. And what you don't know is it's being run by a group of thugs, anti-white thugs. And why do I say that? Am I trying to be incendiary? No, because we're living in times where the incendiaries are already operating in America. Let me explain something to you. There is a group in New York that will make your hair stand up. There is a group entitled, I wish I could find their name, it's not jumping out at me. Here it is. Here it is. The sponsor of this bill to give illegals all of these rights is a man named Kamara. And he's chairman of the New York State Black, Latino, and Asian Caucus. Can you believe you would awaken in America in the year 2014 and there'd be such a racist coalition, a Black, Latino, and Asian caucus that excludes who? Caucasians? So the enemy of what is running who? Did you hear what I just said to you? How do you feel about that? New York Democrats seek citizen rights for illegal immigrants. Now, the state conservative party chairman, Mike Long, said, this is astounding. This undermines our nation's immigration laws. This is absolutely amnesty. It disregards the laws of the United States. But that didn't stop Mayor Bill, the Nicaragua de Blasio, pushing through such similar laws, which created a municipal ID card that provides many, many, many benefits to non-citizens. And I am an immigrant son. Meanwhile, in the Middle East, a British female jihadist, medic, is seen pictured holding a severed head. A 21-year-old vermin who was a British medical student before fleeing to Syria has posted an image on Twitter of herself holding up a cut-off head. In the picture, which has since been taken down from the site, this human vermin can be seen in her white medical coat and full burqa, clearly holding up the head as children look on in the background. She wrote alongside the image, dream job, terrorist doc, followed by love hearts and smiley faces. Did you hear what I just said to you? Did you hear what I just said to you? She considers herself a female soldier of God. She is a devout Muslim. She's holding up a severed head. She was living in England on welfare and went to medical school. Here's what someone wrote when they saw the article. So, considering Cameron says that ISIS and all these Muslim nutters aren't Muslims and don't represent it, can we then please start having him and all the other hangers-on start all the conference with, these people aren't British and do not represent the British people in any way? But of course they won't do it. They want to ram it down our throats that these vermin once lived in England and undermine the entire notion of being British. Did you hear what I just say? Look up British in a dictionary, he wrote, and you no longer see a white family sitting down to a cup of tea at a picnic. Now it's an Arab woman with a burqa on holding a severed head while screaming hatred to the West. How progressive, Mr. and Mrs. Liberal. And speaking of liberals, there's no bigger liberals than those at the Old York Times. As you well know, it's the mainstay of the mental disorder called liberalism. Today, there's an article by Roger Cohen entitled The Great Unraveling about the ruination spreading throughout the world, the ruination that Roger Cohen finally has awakened to. And in this lament that Roger Cohen of the New York Times writes, this long lament about how the world is falling apart, there's not one mention of the fact that he and his fellow travelers were those who pushed Obama down our throats. Now you say, can you really blame Obama for the world falling apart? Yes. Yes. He frayed the fabric of society. He's frayed democracy itself. He has attacked the institutions of democracy themselves. He has given this nation pestilence and disease, and he's only just begun. That's my opinion, and it's one man's opinion. I haven't even touched on Ebola. Can anyone listening to this show tell me that there's a public health rationale for sending U.S. military personnel to the heart of the Ebola outbreak, which is spreading like a plague, because it is a plague, to take U.S. troops and put them not only in harm's way, but guarantee that they'll bring the virus back to America? Can you tell me this is by accident? Can you actually tell me that despite the fact that some military personnel are saying, wait a minute, why are you doing this? Obama and the other clowns in the Defense Department are still going to send U.S. troops to Africa to combat Ebola? This makes no sense from any point of view. I was watching a TV show the other night, last night, about U.S. generals going back to really great American generals, Colin Powell, Arnold General Schwarzkopf. Remember him? McChrystal, I'm trying to recall some of the names, and I don't mean to disrespect any of the generals who were mentioned who were not great generals. They were, with the exception of one who I take exception to, and that's General Wesley Clark. He became a marionette of Bill Clinton. I have no respect for Wesley Clark whatsoever. He's another John Kerry, a politician, never really a general to me. But the others, I would do anything they wish to do. Anything. They're great men. But where are they? Where are the great generals of today? We don't know who they are. Do they exist anymore? Well, we had some really good ones right after Benghazi. Obama threw them out of the military. Four of them. I name them all in the coming civil war. Yes, that's right. I have the names of the generals he threw out after the Benghazi debacle. That's right. They're all named there. The phone number today is 855-400-7282. And I will tell you this. The women are frightened. The women of America are frightened because of the spinelessness and the treachery of this administration and every one of the parties that works for this president of ours. The women are frightened because they see these psychotic serial murderers who are very religious Muslims. Make no mistake about it. I keep hearing that they're not Muslims. I didn't say all Muslims are terrorists, did I? But it's pretty sure that all these jihadis are Muslims. I mean, let's be clear. I mean, let's stop mincing words here. The women are frightened in America. They're frightened because they're counting on the men to protect them. And there are no men to protect them. Oh, there are men who are tough enough to go over there and gut them. There are men tough enough to go over there and drop the bombs necessary to wipe them off the planet and make sure they never return. But they're not working in this government. They've been expunged from this government. They've been deleted from this government. They've been whited out from this government. You get the picture? It's the Savage Nation. I'll be right back.